नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया. माय नेम इज मनीषा सिंह. टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू मैन्युफैक्चर एंड स्टोरेज एंड द प्रोडक्ट डिटेरियोरेशन ऑफ द फूड प्रोडक्ट. देन हार्वेस्टिंग. हार्वेस्टिंग इज द इनिशियल स्टेज इन सप्लाई चेन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड दिस इज अ क्रिटिकल टाइम फॉर ग्रोअर्स एज ओवरऑल इंटीग्रिटी कैन नॉट इम्प्रूव आफ्टर दिस पॉइंट. देयरफॉर आइटम्स विल बी नीड to be packed and shipped with care to avoid the additional and preventable damage. Reduced prices are dependent on physical condition. Fruits and vegetables are still considered living organisms after harvest. However, post-harvest longevity is limited. The rate of deterioration depends on how fast water and nutrient reserves are depleted. If harvested crops sustain damage, the rate of deterioration increases. Therefore, careful harvesting is the first step for successful, safe journey to the retail outlets. Next is the packaging. Fruits and vegetables are especially sensitive foods, and large produce quantities need proper packaging to minimize losses in the most cost-effective way. Each time crops are handled to repackaged, the chance of irreversible damage increases. To protect crops during this stage, certain precautions need to be noted, and wooden crates may have rough surfaces, sharp nails, and staples. If containers are overpacked, compression damage will occur when they are stacked. Dropping and or throwing containers as well as any additional rough handling will cause further damage. Container sizes used should be easy to handle and maneuver. These containers are of a uniform size that reduces excess handling and provide better stacking and loading qualities. Next is shipping. Food is transported from producers to packing houses or processing plants and from processors to retail markets. It is important that fresh foods are shipped quickly and efficiently as they are perishable and susceptible to injury. Refrigerated trucks, railroad cars, and cargo ships are all modes of transportation used, sometimes in conjunction with each other on long journeys. Airplane use is typically reserved for highly perishable items such as fish, or expensive foods such as live lobsters. Throughout the shipping stage, food products need to be carefully loaded and protected to prevent damage from a wide assortment of potential hazards. Loads need to be positioned accordingly to fit inside transportation containers efficiently and remain stable. For example, proper stacking is necessary to prevent shifting or collapsing. In other cases, foods need to be protected from vibrations and jolts, and this may be prevented by special packaging materials or if being shipped by truck, equipping the trailer with shock absorbers and low pressure tires. Storage and shelf life. Storage for most meats and seafood and produce involves some sort of refrigeration. Their storage and shelf lives are dependent on biological and environmental conditions. Warm temperatures will increase the natural enzymatic breakdown rate in foods. As produce is considered a living organism after harvest, food and water reserves will become depleted, causing spoilage. Microbiological organisms may also penetrate natural openings or broken surfaces, causing decay. Cool storage temperatures slow down natural biological processes and decay in the foods we eat. Many fresh, seasonal, and highly perishable food crops are processed to preserve the nutrients and avoid wastage. Processing expands the consumer's choices and allow for the greater flexibility. Then major causes of food spoilage and damage in the supply chain. A United Nations Foods and Agriculture Organization report estimates 30% to 50% of the world's food is wasted due to the losses occurring during harvest, storage, transport, sales, and home usage. Food waste in the supply chain can be caused by proper infrastructure and transportation and inadequate market facilities, poor packaging, quality standards and grading, food manufacture, poor environmental conditions during display at retail, lack of proper planning at restaurants and institutional outlets, excessively restrained best before and use by dates, and leftovers at point of consumption. In developed markets such as Europe and North America, 9% of food loss and waste occurs during handling and storage stage of the value chain. Minimizing losses at this stage are especially important in reducing overall loss and waste, as physical or temperature-related damage during this stage can lead to increased deterioration later in the value chain. An additional 5% of food loss and waste occurs during distribution and marketing. Most packaged food deterioration and spoilage occurs when the container is opened or compromised to the external environment. Knowledge of the various types of spoilages and contaminants allows packaging and processing firms to choose the correct material for their products. Microbiological spoilage. This is the major factor in food spoilage. A host of microorganisms may flourish in foods and they multiply rapidly within the food and produce byproducts that cause chemical changes to affect color, texture, flavor, or nutritional value. These containments may also release toxins, which leads to illness or even death. Next is biochemical, that refers to the enzymatic deterioration. And enzymes are naturally found in plant and animal tissues that control digestion and respiration. Upon harvest, these enzymes begin to destroy the tissue and cause spoilage. Some enzymes come in contact with the food as a product of microbial growth, and they have several main functions of which food processors and packaging professionals should be aware. First, enzymes can act as a catalyst and accelerate the rate of chemical reactions that occur. Second is, specific enzymes may be modified to produce desired longevity and effects. Proper packaging methods and materials can slow enzymatic activity. Containers that maintain low temperatures, protect water activity levels, and maintain appropriate oxygen flow will help keep foods fresher and longer. Then chemical oxidation is the major chemical reaction that leads to spoilage, and certain components and characteristics contained in foods such as fats and vitamins are susceptible to atmospheric oxygen. It also promotes mold growth. Other sources of chemical changes are caused by light and components in the packaging material. These reactions cause flavor alteration and discoloration, surface damage, and decay. Then macrobiological spoilage. This is caused by insects, rodents, birds, and pilfering by the humans. And initial damage incurred by these factors may be minor and could be overlooked. However, even the most minor tissue wounds will make food more susceptible to microbial spoil damage, causing the food to be inedible and lead to sickness or death. Next is physical deterioration. Physical injuries can be classified as mechanical and physiological. Mechanical damage leads to the spoilage because it may cause bruising or deep punctures that cause water loss and rapid decay in the fruits and vegetables or other undesirable effects for other food products. Mechanical effects may result from impact or shock associated with dropping, throwing, or sudden starting and stopping of a vehicle. Vibration damage may also result from various transportation methods, including truck, train, airplane, and boats. Compression and crushing are caused by flimsy or oversized containers. Overfilled containers and containers stacked too high and unable to support heavy loads. Physiological deterioration may increase the natural deterioration because of the high temperatures, low humidity, and other physical injuries. Hope you all are satisfied with this session. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. If you have any query, please mention it in a comment box. I will resolve them whenever we have a live session. Thank you so much for watching this video.